Hey students, a very good morning. So students, we are going through chapter number 5. And the name of the chapter is Separation of Substances. And I hope all of you remember the last point that we discussed. That was winnowing. And we are going through the topic that is separation of solid substances from a mixer. So students, now we are going to start with the fourth one, that is sieving. Okay, so when the components of a mixer are of different sizes, a sieve can be used to separate them. So students, whenever there's a mixer of different sizes in a component, then what can we do? We can make use of a sieve. Okay, for example, this one is a sieve. So a sieve is a shallow vessel that has small holes. So this is a shallow vessel that has a very small holes. The size of the hole in the sieve depends on the size of the component to be separated. So students, the hole depends on the size of the component that is used to be separated. Okay, if the size is very small, then the hole will be very small size. And if the size of the component are of little bigger size, then the hole will also be a little bigger one. Okay, students? So, the method of separating the components of a mixture that are of different sizes by using a sieve is called sieving. So, students, this is the definition of sieving. It is the method of separating the component of a mixture that are of different size. Okay? So, this method is used in some home to separate wheat bran from the flour. So, students, the process of sieving is also used at our home, okay? So, whenever we used to separate the wheat bran from our flour, then we used to make use of sieve. So, I think you know the meaning of wheat bran. So, bran is a piece of grain husk that is separated from the flour after milling. Okay, so here also we make use of the sieve. So you must have noticed similar larger sieve being used at building construction sites to separate the pebbles and the stone from the sand. So students, I hope you have seen the construction of a building. There also the uses of sieve have been seen. So this is the process of sieving of a pebbles and the stone from the sand. Okay, so while the construction of building, there need to be the separation of the pebbles and the stone from the sand. So for that also a sieve is used. Okay students, so pebbles are the small stones that are made smooth and round by the action of the water. Okay, so these are the small and they are very smooth kind of stone. Okay students, so here you can see using fine wheat flour is not considered a healthy practice because during sieving the useful roughage is lost from the flour. So students, when the wheat flour is very fine, then it is not a healthy practice if we sieve them. Why? Because while doing so, we may lost a very useful roughage from the flour. Okay, so now we are going to understand the activity number 2. To understand the process of sieving. So now we are going to understand the process of sieving with the help of activity. So students, for that we need some wheat flour, some pulses and colored chalk powder and sieve. Okay, so the method goes like this. Take 100 gram of wheat flour and mix it with some pulses. Put the mixture of wheat flour and pulses in a sieve. Move the sieve back and forth repeatedly. So students, at first you have to take 100 grams of wheat flour and then you have to mix it with some pulses. Okay, so you have to mix it with some pulses. Then put the mixture of wheat flour and pulses in a sieve. After that you have to put it in a sieve. Suppose this is a sieve. Okay, so here both 100 gram of flour and pulses, you have to mix both this and you have to put in the sieve and then you have to move it back and forth. That means back and forth, back and forth. Okay students, so after that take 100 gram of wheat flour and mix it with colored chalk powder. Then again you have to take 100 gram of wheat flour, similarly wheat flour, and mix it with chalk powder. Okay, then you have to mix it with the color chalk powder. Okay students, then put the mixture of the wheat flour and the color chalk powder in a sieve and move it back and forth repeatedly. So again you have to move it back and forth repeatedly. Okay students, then what you observe is, you observe that the wheat flour passes through the sieve but the pulses are left behind the sieve. So if you have put both the pulses, and suppose these are the pulses, bigger one is pulses and the small one is a wheat flour, then what you observe is you will get all the small, that means you will get the wheat flour are passed through the sieve and the bigger one remains on the sieve. Okay, so number two you observe that chalk powder could not be separated from the wheat flour because on moving the sieve no wheat flour or the chalk powder remains in the sieve. So students, in number two we have observed that both the chalk powder and wheat flour, they fall down from the sieve. So this one is a sieve, this one are the chalk powder and this one is a wheat flour. So we observe that both the chalk powder and the wheat flour will come down from the sieve. Why? Because both the chalk powder and the wheat flour are of same size. Okay, so as the size is same, they get mixed together and they come out from the sieve together. Okay, for that there's no remaining of any of the substances, whether it's a chalk powder or the wheat flour. Okay, so discussion, the size of the pulses is bigger than the size of the hole in the sieve. Hence, the pulses could not pass through the holes and are left behind in the sieve while the flour passes through the holes. So students, in case of number one, the size of the pulses are bigger, okay, than the hole. So they remain back in the sieve, okay. And as the size of the wheat flour are smaller, so they come out from the sieve, okay. So I hope it is clear to you. It's very easy. As the size was bigger, so it remains in the sieve, and the size of the wheat flour are smaller, so they come out of the sieve. And in case of number two, the size of wheat flour and the chalk powder is smaller than the size of the sieve hole. So in case of number two, in case of wheat flour and the chalk powder, the size of both the chalk powder and the wheat flour are smaller than the size of the hole. So the flour and the chalk powder pass through it. Hence, sieving is used for separation when the component of the mixer have different sizes. Okay, so from here we can understand that sieving can only be used for separating any substance only if they have different sizes. Okay, so in case of chalk powder and wheat flour, it was not useful. Why? Because the size was same. And in case of the wheat flour and the pulses, it was useful. Why? Because the size was different. Okay, students. So in conclusion, you see, sieving can also be used to separate the component of a mixer of different sizes. So in conclusion, we come to know that sieving can only be used to separate the component of a mixer of different sizes. Okay, so with this we complete this point. Now we are going to understand about the separation of insoluble substance from a liquid. Till now we are going or understanding about the separation of solid substance, but now we are going to understand about the liquids. Okay, so number one is sedimentation and decantation. So I hope you know the meaning of sedimentation. If not, we are going to understand it by now. So insoluble substances that are heavier than the liquid can be separated by sedimentation. So insoluble means that which cannot be mixed in water, okay, that remains suspended. So insoluble substances that are heavier than the liquid, those kind of substances can be separated by this process of sedimentation and decantation. Okay, students. So let us perform the following activity to understand this process. So activity 3, to separate sand and water from their mixture by sedimentation and decantation. So we can make use of, we can separate both sand and water from their mixture by sedimentation and decantation. So for that we need 2 beakers, a glass rod, mixture of sand and water. So 3 things are required: beaker, glass rod and a mixture of sand and water. So method: take a mixture of sand and water in a beaker. So at first you have to take a mixture of sand and water in a beaker like this. Allow the mixture to stand undisturbed for some time. So you have to allow it to rest for some time. Okay, after some time, pour the clean water into another beaker gently with the help of a glass rod without disturbing the sediment of sand. So after some time, you just have to pour the clean water into another beaker and very gently with the help of a glass rod. Okay, so without disturbing the sediment of the sand. So this one is the second one. So what do you observe after that is, on allowing the mixture to stand undisturbed, you observe that the heavier sand particles settle down at the bottom of the beaker. So you see, for allowing it to stand for some time, what do we observe? We observe that the heavier sand particles, they settle down in the bottom of the beaker in figure number 5.6. So you can see over here, this layer of sand is called sediment. So students, this layer of sand, this one, wait, I'm going to show you. So this layer of sand is known as sediment. So when the sand settles down, clear water remains above the layer of sand. So you can see this clear water remains in the upper portion and the sand remains undisturbed in the lower portion. So number 2, when all the clean water has been poured out, only sand is left at the bottom of the beaker. So in number 2, we have just poured out all the clean water in another beaker and the sand is left in the older one, okay, in the previous beaker. So this process is known as decantation. So in conclusion, we found that sand and water can be separated from the mixture first by sedimentation and then by decantation. So this process is known as sedimentation, and this portion is known as decantation. Okay, this process is known as decantation. So now we are going to understand about the definition. The process of settling down of heavier insoluble particle at the bottom of liquid is called sedimentation. So, this is sedimentation, the process of settling down of the heavier insoluble particles at the bottom of the liquid, that is known as sedimentation. And the heavier insoluble particles that settle down at the bottom of the liquid is called sediments. Okay, so this is known as sediment. And the process of pouring out a clean liquid from a vessel after sedimentation without disturbing the sediment is called the decantation. So this was the process of sedimentation, and this is the process of decantation. So it is the process of pouring out a clean liquid from the vessel after sedimentation. Okay. So I think and I hope it is clear to you. The process of sedimentation and decantation can be used for separating two immiscible liquid like the oil and liquid. Immiscible means insoluble. Okay. So this process can be used for separating the liquid like the oil and water. So when a mixture of oil and water is allowed to stand for some time, oil forms a separate layer on water. Oil is then separated by decantation. So you can take one beaker, you can put some water over here, and you have to put some oil, and you need to keep it in rest for some time, and after that you find that the water will settle down and oil will settle in the upper portion. So after that you can just separate the oil in another beaker, then that process will be said as decantation. So I hope it is clear to you. Now these are the MCQs you need to do it after completing this video. So yeah, I hope we are going to stop over here. Tomorrow we will start with the filtration. Okay, so thank you and have a good day.